This is the next question we have. It says, select the correct statement. First option is H2O2 has a planar structure. Second statement is decomposition of H2O2 on exposure to light becomes slow in the presence of metal surface or traces of alkali. Third statement is H2O2 has a high dielectric constant as compared to water. The fourth statement is H2O2 is miscible with water in all proportion. So students, the first statement is false. H2O2 has open book structure or laptop type structure. So hence it cannot be a planar structure. If I talk about the second statement, this is also false. Why it is false? With presence of metal surface or traces of alkali, the process becomes faster. Third statement is also false. Water has higher dielectric constant. And fourth statement is correct. It is a true statement. H2O2 forms hydrogen bond with water. Hence, it is miscible with water in all proportion. So the correct answer for this question is option 4. Now let us move to the next question. This is the next question we have. It says, out of the following species that can act as both oxidizing as well as reducing agent is R. First is given N2O3, second is N2H4, third is FeSO3, fourth is H4P2O6, fifth is H2S2O7. So students, let's write their oxidation state. If I talk about oxidation state of nitrogen here, it is +3. In N2H4, the nitrogen has the oxidation state of -2. In FeSO3, the iron has an oxidation state of +2 and S sulfur has an oxidation state of +4. Now if I talk about H4P2O6, the oxidation state of phosphorus here will be, you can calculate, 12 minus 4 by 2, that is +4. If I talk about H2S2O7, that is oleum, this will have sulfur with oxidation state +6. If I talk about nitrogen, nitrogen can have oxidation state minimum -3 and maximum +5. Again, -3 to +5. Here, if I talk about sulfur, it can have oxidation state from -2 to +6. In this case, the oxidation state can be from -3 to +5 for phosphorus. The oxidation state of sulfur can be from -2 to +6. Now, if I talk about this oxidation state, +3, it is in between -3 and +5. So it can oxidize as well as reduce. So it will act as oxidizing as well as reducing agent. Similarly, -2 can be reduced to -3 and it can be oxidized till +5 oxidation state. So it can act as oxidizing as well as reducing agent. Again, if I talk about FeSO3, it has sulfur with +4 oxidation state. So +4 oxidation state can be reduced to -2 or +2 and it can be oxidized to +6 also. So because it can be oxidized as well as reduced, hence it can act as both oxidizing as well as reducing agent. The same case is with phosphorus here. It can be oxidized to +5 oxidation state and it can be reduced till -3 oxidation state. So it can act as both oxidizing as well as reducing agent. But if I talk about the last option, which is fifth option, it has the sulfur with oxidation state +6. This cannot be oxidized further, but it can be reduced. So it can act as oxidizing agent, but not reducing agent. So first, second, third, and fourth. These all four can act as oxidizing as well as reducing agent. So the correct answer for this question will be option 4. Now let's move to the next question. This is the next question we have. It says, in which of the following option, the type of redox reaction is not correctly matched with the given example. First option is decomposition reaction, metal displacement, non-metal displacement, combination reaction. Students, if I talk about the second option here, it's not a metal displacement because non-metal is being displaced. That's why this is not the correct matched example. Hence, the correct answer for this question will be option 2. Now, let us move to the next question. This is the next question we have. It says, a certain amount of metal X having equivalent weight E1 displaces W gram of another metal Y having equivalent weight E2 from its salt solution. The amount of metal X in gram used in the process is, the first option is W gram. The second option is E1 by E2 into W gram. Third option is E2 by E1 into W gram. Fourth option is root under E1 into multiply by W gram. Students, hum yahan jante hain ki number of equivalents of X should be equal to number of equivalents of Y. So I'm writing here equivalence of x will be equal to equivalence of y. So equivalence of x will be equal to mass of x by, let us say mass of x is w1, by equivalent weight of x. That will be equal to mass of y given divided by equivalent mass of y. So from here we can find the value of w1, that will be e1 by e2 into w. So the weight of x will be equal to e1 by e2 into w, which is option 2. Hence the correct answer for this question will be option 2. Now let us move to the next question. This is the next question we have. It says 65 ml of x molar NaOH solution is treated with 20 ml of 0.2 molar HCl solution. The resultant solution further required 10 ml of 0.3 molar S3PO4 solution for complete neutralization. The value of x is, these are the options given, 0.5 molar, 5 molar, 0.2 molar and 1 molar. Students, it is a neutralization reaction. यहां पर हमारे पास दो एसिड्स हैं HCl और H3PO4 और यहां पर हमारे पास क्या है सोडियम हाइड्रोक्साइड विच इज अ बेस. सो वी कैन सिंपली से इक्विवेलेंस ऑफ एसिड इज इक्वल्स टू इक्विवेलेंस ऑफ बेस. तो यहां पर हम पहले निकालते हैं एसिड के इक्विवेलेंट. एसिड के इक्विवेलेंट क्या हो गए, एसिड है HCl, सो वॉल्यूम ऑफ HCl मल्टीप्लाई बाय मोलारिटी ऑफ HCl इनटू एन फैक्टर ऑफ HCl प्लस वॉल्यूम ऑफ S3PO4 मल्टीप्लाई बाय मोलारिटी ऑफ S3PO4 मल्टीप्लाई बाय एन फैक्टर विच इज 3. बेस के इक्विवेलेंट कितने हो गए, वॉल्यूम ऑफ बेस मल्टीप्लाई बाय मोलारिटी ऑफ बेस विच इज x multiply by n factor of base which is 1. So we can solve here, it will be 4 by 1000 plus 9 by 1000, that is equals to 65 by 1000 into x. So from here we can find the value of x, that is 13 by 65 or it will be equal to 0.2. So the molarity of NaOH solution will be 0.2 molar. So the correct answer for this question is option 2. Now let us move to the next question.